greatest things about Cache Valley is Cache Valley Center for the Arts. Wally, the season is upon us. You've been working super hard. What do we have to look forward to this season?
Well, this is going to be a really busy season. Let me tell you, we've got a lot of things lined up, starting in the very beginning with the Manhattan transfer, going all the way through the spring with Bobby McFerrin. Lots and lots of things happening on the stage right behind us. It's going to be a busy year.
Now, this is, I wish that I could be behind the scenes, because a lot of us, we purchase our tickets, we come to the show, we enjoy it, we go home. We have no idea what goes on behind the scenes. How long have you been working on getting the season ready?
Well, each year we work on the next season, and right now I'm looking at things in 2014, which is kind of hard to think about. In fact, I had a story about a friend of mine who actually had that same issue. He was thinking so far in the future, he wrote a check and put next year's date on it. And it's like, wait a minute, you're thinking that far out? Yeah, we've got to. In fact, there are things out there for 14-15 that are already being decided. But yes, each year we work for the next season, looking at putting together a combination of music and dance and straight drama and all kinds of fun things for the whole valley to enjoy.
What is so great about the Cache Valley Center for the Arts is there is always a vast array of different things that are coming to the theater that appeal to so many different people. And just looking at your poster, it just looks jam-packed this year.
Yeah, we try and make it jam-packed. Each year we count on a number of partners. Of course, we bring in the national touring acts, the big name entertainers, if you will, that are involved, the artists that really you wouldn't see otherwise if we wouldn't bring them in. They aren't just going to show up and do Cats on Stage or something like that, like we've had through the years. But we've got many, many local partners that do real well, all the different community theater groups, the dance groups. And then we have some promoters that just come in and bring in some of the other people. So it's a varied season of lots and lots of different things.
Now, there's something we need to talk about, because the arts is expensive. The building is expensive, just to heat, you were telling me that. And the arts need a lot of support from people in our community. What's one way they can support having the arts come?
Well, that's a good point. Thank you. There's a lot that's involved in it. Of course, each year we go out and we solicit sponsors. The business community is very helpful. Banks and foundations and lots of businesses are very helpful in that regard. But we also solicit membership. Individual people can help become a member of the center, even at $25, $100, $1,000, whatever they'd like to help us out with. The fact is, tickets are only provide about 30 to 40% of the actual cost of anything that goes on the stage here. It's really amazing. People think, well, that's an expensive amount for a ticket. Well, it's not like a movie. You got real life people on the stage there. And actually, they expect to get paid every night, it turns out. So when we have a national touring act, you know, some of the costs of those, some of the large ones that bring in 3 and 4 tractor trailer trucks are very expensive. So we do promote membership. And memberships get a little special privileges. You know, they might find out about things a little bit earlier than other people. They might get another thing of water at the concession counter. We provide a little incentive to them, but it's just a way of allowing them to help us out and make the theater work financially for everyone.
Well, another good thing I think is to bring up is the ticket sales are really quite affordable, and you keep it that way, because otherwise we're looking at, you know, what people pay on Broadway, because those are the kind of shows that you bring, and so being a member really helps keep those costs down. What else do you use to help fund Cache Valley Center for the Arts?
Well, we do a lot of different things. We're always looking for assistance any way that we can. One of the things we've found very successful in the last 10 years is the RAPS program, the Recreation Arts Park Zoos program. That's going to be coming up for a vote again in November. So we're hoping people will remember that that's helped us out, helped many, many organizations, and just about every city in the valley has had something built through the RAPS program. So that's a significant part that, and it's 0.1 cent on a dollar, so like a penny on $10. You don't even notice it, but in the aggregate, it really makes a difference for the theater and for many other organizations and just about every city in the county, too.
Well, it's such a beautiful theater, and anybody that's ever come here, that's even traveled here, I've seen people walk through here myself and just say, this is unbelievable that your little valley has this beautiful facility, and you bring great things here for our valley for everyone to enjoy.
Well, you know, it's interesting. We get people who do go to Broadway on a regular basis, and they come here and they say, you know, there are several theaters on Broadway that this Ellen Eccles is much better than. Horribly conducted phrase, but it really is. You go to some of those theaters and you're really squashed in, and it's a little different, and you're paying $200 for a ticket,
right?
And you're not paying that here.
Well, there's tons of great shows coming up. This is the time of year. You've got to be so excited, because you work so hard, and now the season is upon us, and we've got stuff running from, tell me, the dates from when to when?
Well, we start early in September with Les Mis. We go all the way through to the end of April, actually, with the dance groups and just a lot of things in between. We'll talk a little bit about that later, but there's a whole lot of things going on here at the Cache Valley Center for the Arts.
Let's also talk about the website, because I myself have purchased tickets online and found it very user-friendly. So what's your website of address?
Sure, the easiest one is cachearts.org, C-A-C-H-E, cachearts.org. And that's easy to remember because we're in Cache Valley, cachearts.org. And you can buy tickets online, 2 o'clock in the morning if you want to. And there's no additional charge. You come down to the box office, it's the same price as buying them online. That's the decision we made early to make that easy for people to do. And we're finding over half of the tickets that we sell now are done online because people find that convenient. They can print them out, they've got it right there in front of them, they just walk right on in, there's no problem. Makes it easy and allows people to make a spur-of-the-moment decision. Let's do that tomorrow. Oh, I don't want to have to go down to the theater. Boom, you're done. So it's very handy.
There's also a phone number they can call as well.
Sure, 752-0026 is our box office number. That's very helpful to get people in if they want to find out a little more details about something. Go to the website. We've got lots of videos and information on the website. So if they want to learn a little bit more about, what is Miracle on 34th Street? What is that all about? I remember the movie, but, that's a good way to look at it, too.
Well, it's very exciting. Please support our theaters. Great little gem we have here right in our valley.